after I finished studying my job as a dental technician, I put like the break of 2 years, and after 2 years I became first time world champion in cyclocross. That was in 85. 2 years later, so in 87, I became again world champion for the second time. In January 88 was the world championship in cyclocross in Switzerland. It was raining, I mean, really badly, and from that 3 kilometer loop, we had to run with our bike on the shoulder like 1.5 kilometer, and that was making sense to me. And so I was kind of like boycotting the race and stopped the race. And yeah, that gave me, put me like in a lot of trouble with the UCI. That was the purpose why I couldn't go to the Olympics in 88. And that actually let me stop and quit cycling. I put my bike in the cellar and I traveled to my girlfriend to California. I was living there for a year. And then eventually, a little bit later, I got a call as they wanted to have me at a mountain bike race in Berlin. And at that time, I had no clue what's mountain biking. And I said, yeah, it's kind of a cyclocross race, but the tires are bigger and the handlebars wider and straight. And I was saying, okay, let me check a bicycle shop and then I will let you know. And so I saw these bikes and I thought, wow, very interesting. This could be like fun riding with these bikes. And yeah, in the first race I became second, very close. Yeah, everybody was excited because I was new in this sport at the time. And so like a new professional sport started for me. The World Championship in 1992, I wasn't successful for a couple of years, and I know I had to change something. At that time I was living in Berlin, and I was getting a little bit too much involved with the nightlife in Berlin, what is not difficult because it's really fun. So I had to figure out something, and what was, I mean, changing my life at that time was the movie Sylvester Stallone, Rocky Number 4. He, at that time, I don't know if you guys remember, there was a, Apollo was fighting against a Russian guy, and then he lost and he got killed in the fight, and then Rocky had to take revenge, and the coach said, you know what, he will kill you as well, and anyways, you're living in your luxury life. So if you want to fight against a Russian guy, you have to live under the same, in the same situation like he. So he left to Russia in a wooden house up in the mountains and was getting ready for the fight, and he of course beat him. And for me it was moving into the Black Forest, where I'm still living today, and I was getting ready for the World Championship, and I became world champion in 92. I mean, I didn't want to wait longer to start with my own brand, because at one point it's too late. As long as I was riding, like still riding as a professional rider, I could promote the bikes by myself. I mean, maybe it sounds funny, but I know that I'm being good in this. So I thought, you know, I should take advantage of promoting my own bikes while I was racing. And at one point there was no way of like turning around. I had to continue, but I was very confident because I just saw like focus will be good. We will go to the top. So now let's one more make one more like you like you talk about something. I talk to you about something. Do you? No, it is about the engine. The engine is there, not there. The engine is. It should go a little bit faster. You understand?
Yeah. I think the engine needs to be like more like here, and the shock needs to be there.
Why?
So it can be faster.
Higher engine.
Right.
Good engine. That I'm here.
Right. It's better. A higher weight means better handling.